Soil health is crucial. If you don't have any soil health, you see the difference right away. It's like a desert there. You can't grow in the desert. You need to have soil health and to have a good soil structure to retain water, to reduce compaction, reduce erosion. It's crucial. My name is Paul Poitras. I'm a farmer in the St. Andre area in New Brunswick, and I farm potato with my dad and my grandfather and my uncle. And we're farming around 400 acres of potato a year. And I've been doing that for the past 10, 15 years, maybe. St. Andre has a lot of hill around here, and we do have some terraces to control soil erosion. Everybody does grow potato here. That's the major economy of the place. We got a lot of rocks, that's for sure. But we pick the rock and we plant around them. Potato, it's a crop that you cultivate the soil a lot. And erosion becomes more of an issue when you break the structure of the soil. And here we try to reduce our cultivation as much as we can. We don't plow in the fall anymore. We all plow this spring with a disc ripper instead, not a conventional plow. And instead of hilling our plant after it's planted, well, we got a hiller in the back of the planter that was doing it at the same time to help reduce soil erosion. But time saving is a big one. You only work the soil once, you don't work it back afterwards. So. And with the fuel cost that we have this year, it will help for sure. This spring was a challenging spring for this year, but everything did well with it. And I'm quite anxious to see the result in the fall when you're gonna harvest it. Last year, this field was planted in two different rotation crops. There's one section that was planted with a sorghum Sudan grass, and the other section was planted with brown mustard, and it was plowed under and then planted with tillage radish. And we could see the line in that field, the difference between the mustard and the Sudan grass. The Sudan grass, the plant seems to be a lot greener. It left more residue on top because we passed a disc ripper, not the plow there. So everything stays on top, and you could see a big difference between the Sudan grass and the brown mustard, a very big difference. And I believe it makes a difference when it's decomposing too. It must help with the soil. Maybe we could try like planting a mustard and then come back with Sudan grass and plant it with the hiller to biofumigate first and then plant the Sudan grass after. So it won't be flat, it will be all hilly. So there's more surface area that the sun can heat at a time. And since the row is all up, it's gonna dry faster in the spring, so you could get earlier in the field in the spring. That's the idea. So, and since the Sudan grass died in the winter, so it's not really a big issue in the spring to plow or harrow or plant or whatever there. I don't know, there's a lot of plenty of opportunity to try, but we'll have to discuss that with my father. So I like to always improve myself and how I farm and everything. I love the challenge.